Hey guys, Jeremy here with KISS Aquatic Systems. KISS. Keep it simple, stupid. Today's video is going to be about flukes and koi, a not so pleasant pairing. So, if you keep koi, flukes are just one of those unfortunate facts of life that you are probably going to have to deal with at some point or other. I'd actually go as far as to say that flukes are probably the single koi parasite that gives folks the most trouble overall. Now, there's three main reasons for this. One, they're extremely, extremely common, to the point where I'd expect most ponds to have at least a few at any given time, whether the fish are flashing or not. Two, while flukes are generally not a problem in low levels, serious infestations of flukes can definitely damage or even kill your fish. And three, on top of all that, these little buggers are extremely hard to kill. So putting all that together, you've got a parasite here that's a real bundle of joy. Now, flukes are a type of parasitic flatworm that has done quite well for itself, actually. There are over 10,000 different species of flukes that infest pretty much every kind of vertebrate, including humans, by the way, and many inverts as well. So some folks like to differentiate between gill flukes, which are egg layers, and skin flukes, which are live bearers. But for me, these informal names aren't particularly useful or helpful, as both types of flukes can be found both on gill and skin tissue. Also, the treatment regimens for gill and skin flukes are pretty much identical. So for me, they're all just flukes. So, there are clearly a number of different approaches to flukes and koi health and stuff in general. But for me, I see flukes and parasites overall as sort of a fact of life or a force of nature. Really just something that just has to be managed rather than completely eradicated. The reason for that is twofold. One, trace elements of parasite really isn't a problem at all. And two, complete elimination is almost impossible. And for me, the process of attempting a complete kill of all flukes is it's just too hard on the koi in terms of the kinds of chemicals that are needed. And quite frankly, has too low a success rate to justify the effort. So my drug of choice to control flukes is praziquantel. I like it because it's both highly effective at killing adult flukes, and because it is probably the safest and most benign medication for koi in existence. In all seriousness, it's the only drug I know of where significant overdoses don't typically cause problems for koi, and prazi is actually a fairly common standard medication taken orally by people. Also to treat flukes and internal worms. Obviously different species, though. On the other hand, I'm not sure doctors will be prescribing their human patients oral doses of formaldehyde or potassium permanganate anytime soon. Or a lot of the other stuff that passes for medication, quote unquote, in the ornamental fish keeping hobby. Now, that's not to say that the strong stuff isn't sometimes necessary. It's just that as a preventative or early stage fluke treatment, I prefer to start with the fairly gentle prazi. And fortunately for me and for my koi over the years, that has been more than enough by itself. So when buying prazi, I just look for the active ingredient. It should say 100% praziquantel powder. I don't like to waste my time or money buying any of those cute, catchy sounding branded products. And quite frankly, with a 5,000 gallon koi pond connected to a 1,000 gallon upper pond, the price tag really does start to add up at those levels. So just stick to pure praziquantel powder from any trusted vendor, and you will save a decent chunk of money. 10 grams of the stuff does treat 1,000 gallons of pond water. Or if measuring powder out by hand, one level tablespoon treats 500 gallons of water. Now that's the generally accepted dose, which is actually a bit higher than the clinically effective concentration of 2 parts per million or about 7.5 grams per 1,000 gallons. But the stuff can degrade rather quickly once it hits your pond, so it does make sense to follow those generally accepted dosing instructions. Now, for the drug to work, it needs to mix in with your pond water, which can be a bit tricky as the powder doesn't really like to dissolve all that quickly. What I do is I add a few tablespoons of the powder at a time to a 1-quart container of pond water. Seal the container with a lid, and then really, really shake it. Not side to side, but rather up and down, so that the powder sitting at the top of the water is forced into the mixture. When I have a nice slurry going, I dump it into my pond right next to my waterfall return, which spreads it out pretty nicely. So if you do end up with a small amount of residual powder floating on your pond surface, it's generally nothing to worry about. As long as you mixed it well beforehand and got all of the powder wet to some extent, it should disappear and dissolve within a day or two. So now let's talk about drug effectiveness. For flukes in real-world pond environments, prazi should be able to kill a significant percentage of the adult flukes in the system, as well as any newly hatched babies that are foolish enough to enter the water column while the drug is still active. Eggs for the gill flukes and baby skin flukes that are still developing inside their parents will probably not be affected by this or many other treatments, which is why a follow-up dose, call it 4 to 7 days after the first dose, is sometimes recommended to catch them once they emerge. More often than not, I don't really bother with the second dose. But if your fish look like they need it, and if you have enough extra powder on hand, it may not be a bad idea. So during treatment, While most of the adult flukes on your koi will be killed, there are likely to be at least a few that survive. That's because, somewhat ironically actually, the slime coat that your fish produce to protect themselves from parasites could actually end up protecting some of the parasites that are embedded inside it from the medication. Now, that's actually a basic challenge we all face in trying to medicate specifically our koi with anything, not just prazi, as they do tend to have very thick slime coats, especially around the gill area compared to a lot of other fish. Overall, though, prazi is great at knocking back flukes to tolerable levels, which your fish, if they are otherwise healthy, should be able to manage on their own going forward. So I tend to treat my pond sort of as a preventative with prazi in the spring, especially if I see any flashing, which usually is the case in April or May at some point. I've actually just treated these koi here a few days ago, and doesn't look like they're being too moody about it, which is nice. Now, there are a ton of different reasons why koi flash, particularly in the spring with all those seasonal changes that are happening. Many of those reasons really have nothing to do with flukes or parasites at all. But I just sort of assume that I do have a low level of flukes in my pond, and by hitting the fish with a single dose of prazi early in the season, I can knock them back and really prevent any infestation at all from developing while the fish are maybe still a bit groggy from their long winter torpor. Now, aside from spring, I have also had 2 5-day-long power outages in the past 3 summers. In August, when it was really hot out. Actually, kind of terrible. The koi were completely miserable. So, perhaps not surprisingly, after a serious stressor like that, I did start to see some flashing a few weeks later, and what I assumed were flukes. So I treated with prazi, again, a single treatment only, and the flashing disappeared within a few days. So overall, I think that for flukes and parasites in general, if you provide your koi with good, clean water, high-quality food, lots of space, and very importantly, avoid serious stressors, the fish should really be able to take care of themselves and control most parasites without all that much help. That goes for flukes, a lot of the bacterial stuff, all the common protozoans, really almost anything, actually. Maybe a bit of help could be useful in the early spring, during what is commonly called Eremona Alley. But otherwise, koi can be pretty tough and hardy fish. So thanks, folks. That's all on flukes and koi parasites for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Take care, and happy ponding.